And now, for the moment you've been waiting for, let's hit this green run button. It will prompt us to choose a device. Without a physical device, we can test the app using the emulator that comes with the Android SDK. An Android virtual device should have already been created for you automatically when you set up Android Studio. So you can go ahead and click OK. While the emulator is booting up, I want to point out that if you ever want to modify your emulated devices, you can click on this purple button in the Android and open up the AVD manager to manage your Android virtual devices. It lists out your existing devices, and you can always create another virtual device. You can select the category of device and then a specific device. Then you choose which platform version it should be running on, and this is the only one that's available on this computer now. So Lollipop is good, and we choose the Google API's target because it will include some Google services already pre-installed on the emulator. You can choose next. There's a couple more options and settings that you can modify. For example, if you want an SD card or a camera, and then you can go ahead and click finish, and it will create a new AVD for you. When it loads up, we see our Sunshine app with the words Hello World. Keep in mind that the emulator is not just a simulator. It's actually running the Android virtual machine, so you can test and debug your app on different hardware and software configurations. You can interact with the app on the emulator using the screen or with the navigation controls here. You can also invoke other apps, do network calls, play audio or video, and much more. It also includes debug capabilities, including log output and the ability to simulate app interrupts or network latency. You can also hit home and browse around the device to see other apps. For example, you can check out API demos. Feel free to play around with the emulator some more. If you open up Android Device Monitor, you can go into the Emulator Control tab. There you'll see different options for simulating behavior on your AVD, such as for telephony and for location. Now that the Hello World app runs on the emulator, let's see what goes on behind the scenes to make the app run.